Hello, Blake Rudis here with Everyday HDR and HDRinsider.com, and today I want to discuss sharpening, and not just sharpening in the term that you might be used to as far as Unsharp Mask or High Pass Sharpening, but a new technique that might be a little bit better for you than the traditional sharpening that you're used to. So what I've done here is taken a small stem bit from a bigger image so that we can look at how these sharpening layers are going to affect our image. So the first one we have here is the Unsharp Mask, and that's what we're looking at now, and then we have the High Pass Sharpen. And then we have the High Pass Sharpen tool, and that's what I'm going to show you today. Now, I really want you to pay attention to this area up here. So we're going to go ahead and zoom in right on this area up here and take a look at those sharpen methods again. So this is with the Unsharp Mask selected. This is with the High Pass, and this is with the High Pass Sharpen tool. Now, notice the amount of depth that is right here within this one line, and that's going to really point out how well that sharpen turns out. Now, I also want to put out there that while this looks like it's really hyper sharpened, we're zoomed in 150% on something that was already zoomed in 150%. So we're zoomed in about 300% on something. So we'll go ahead and look at that larger image that this all came from. So you can see here I've done quite a bit of work to this photograph. Here was the original, and here it is now. I put a blur layer here, a little tilt shift blur action on the sides. I used the digital zone system, I used the color zone system, and then I used a dodge and burn layer and a nice little curves layer to top it all off. So at this point, I'm pretty much done with this photograph, and all I really need to do now is sharpen it up so that if I were to print it, it would be print ready and ready to go. So what I would normally do is press Control Shift Alt and E, or Command Shift Option and E on a Mac, to make a stamp of everything below. And at this point, I could go to Filter, I could go to Sharpen, and I could go to Unsharp Mask. Now, I typically like to sharpen heavier and then work my way down. Okay, so if I use 140% in the pixels there on the Unsharp Mask, I'm all right with that. So if I zoom in here, you can see that's pretty well sharpened up, right? Now, if I wanted to, I could just drop that opacity down a little bit, and I would use that to sharpen my image to taste. So I sharpen high and then bring it down. Okay, that's just a strategy that I like to use. Start off high and work my way down to low. The only problem with this is that it sharpens the entire photograph. Same thing would happen if I were to press Control Shift Alt E, Command Shift Option E again, and then go to Filter, go to Other, and go to High Pass. And I usually just do a high pass of 0.6. I press Control Shift U to make sure that that's desaturated so I won't get any color noise there. And then I go to Linear Light. And if we zoom in, that's going to give me a really good sharpen, but it's all over the entire photograph. All right, same thing. I'd have to do a lot of masking in order to get all the other stuff out of the way. So what I've come to the conclusion, actually, while I was working on this image, I started doing this, which is totally different for me when it comes to sharpening. It's very selective sharpening, and I actually use the Sharpen tool. So I'm going to go ahead and make a new layer and grab the Sharpen tool, which is over here. It's hidden right within the Blur tool and the Smudge tool. With the Sharpen tool, like many other tools in Photoshop that make adjustments, permanent adjustments to your image, you see here there's something called Sample All Layers. The clone stamp has this, many other tools have this as well. What that means is that you can make a new layer on the top of all of your image and then selectively use the sharpen tool so that you're not doing anything destructive to the rest of the image by sharpening right on the background layer or something to that effect. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in right here to that little branch that we saw in the very beginning. You can see that there's not a whole lot of depth to this branch. Actually, it looks like it might even be slightly out of focus. So if we go ahead and just paint that sharpening on, I'm at 50%. Like I said before, I like to start high and work my way low. I'm actually going to really kind of overdo it with the sharpen tool. And it doesn't look that good because I've really overdone it with the sharpen tool. But if I do a high pass sharpen on the sharpen tool, the results are phenomenal. So what I'm going to do is go to Filter, go to Other, and go to High Pass. Again, that's a 0.6, and I'm going to change that to Linear Light. Now, if I zoom in here, you can see that there's quite a bit of color noise that was associated with that. So if I press Control Shift U on that layer, it will desaturate that and immediately remove all of that color noise that you see here. Look really closely. So here's that color noise. If I desaturate it, I no longer have the color noise that's associated with my sharpen. So if I zoom out to 100%, that sharpen does look a lot better, but again, it might be too much, so I can just drop the opacity a little bit, maybe to about, I don't know, a little bit over 50%. 66% works for me. Look at the amount of depth that we've added to that area. Now I know that a lot of these things can be very easy to forget. So what I've done is I'll just go ahead and zoom into this area. I'll create that new layer, and then I'll go ahead and use the Sharpen tool right here. I'll just sharpen this up nice. Now I've created an action for you. So all you have to do is go where it says Sharpen Tool High Pass, click play. And that will do all of that for you. It's going to make that linear light, it's going to make the high pass, and it's also going to desaturate it. So all you have to do is the sharpening with the pen, with the Sharpen tool, and then you're free to go ahead and use that action to do all the rest of the work for you. Again, it might be a little heavy, so we'll go ahead and drop the opacity there a little bit. Now after I record this action, I'll go ahead and also put some instructions in here for you so that you know exactly what you're supposed to do with that action. So why this can be great is that you can do some very selective sharpening on very selective areas. And if you need to, you can even duplicate that. And if you really want to sharpen it up and really kind of target the eye to that area, you can duplicate those areas too. It's a very powerful way to do your sharpening because it's very selective and it's subjective to what you want to sharpen and what you want the eye to navigate to. So if you're about to print this image and you really want some really nice detail in those areas, you can just over sharpen those areas just really kind of selectively with this technique. But remember, don't go too high on your sharpening. You don't want to create any JPEG artifacting or these little over sharpened, over crisp edges. You just want a nice, clean, almost realistic looking sharpen. So again, my name is Blake Rudis with Everyday HDR and HDR Insider. If you like this, please comment, please share. If you're watching this on YouTube, there's going to be a link at the bottom where you can download this action. If you're watching it on the website, there'll be a link right there that says download so you can grab this action and use it in your workflow. Thank you. Have a great one.